Check, 1-2, check.
Hey, Drew, how you doing?
Pretty good, Tom. How you doing?
Doing good.
Yeah. Like, I don't know about you in Arizona, but I am definitely under quarantine.
I've been out playing golf almost every day. But I've been doing a lot of work, too.
It'll get some work done, but mostly telecommunication, so that's about it.
Yeah, well, golf courses have been deemed an essential service in the state of Arizona. They cannot be shut down, so that's...
Well, the liquor stores are shut down here, and I just had my last sip of Johnny Walker Blue last night.
Most states' liquor stores
are in crisis.
In New York, I found out that cannabis is considered essential.
Yeah, that's why they have all those cases there too.
So just on CNBC, cannabis is essential.
Unbelievable.
Yeah, it's a crazy world.
Okay, now I'm gonna get that. It's kind of boring right now. I haven't been able to do we've been like this for about the last week. It was voluntary last week. Now it's mandatory. Yeah. So, but just people doing stupid things. No discipline at all.
Yeah.
I know I'll be okay because in the basement, I just happen to have this old green charcoal thing on the inside thing and a certain mask. I don't know if the filters are any good by now, but yeah. At least it got some type of protection.
Yeah. So is this a waiting room here, or is this everybody shows up?
I think everybody starts showing up. It's kind of like a waiting room now until 12 o'clock, then you're live.
Okay.
So, hey, what you up to? Come here.
Hey. I'll be back in a moment. I just want to make sure this is all working.
Yeah, it's working pretty good, Tom.
All right.
How you doing?
Alrighty. I got a order of cigars coming in here because I've been having more cigars since I've been sitting around too.
Well, one thing you know about me, Tom, I do have a good supply.
No, I know that.
I'm just running out of the liquid refreshments, that's all.
What state are you in?
Pennsylvania.
Yeah, we might have to go across to New Jersey or Maryland or somewhere.
Actually, New Jersey's shut down worse than we are. They will actually, they're on curfews and they'll fine you. Jeez. Any business open and 30 days in jail.
Yeah.
The communist state of New Jersey.
Wow. Down here in Arizona, we don't have it as much because it's warm and sunny and that kills the virus. And, you know, golf, I think down here is one of the best things you can do. It's got social distancing, you know, you're out in the sun, the heat. I like it. It works out well. They pulled all the rakes off so you can't rake the bunkers because they don't want you touching things. They got,
oh, wow.
They don't want you pulling the pin. They got little plastic things down in the hole so that the ball, you know, doesn't go way down. You don't have to touch the pin when you pick out your ball. I mean, some of it's kind of crazy, but they take it serious. No water. You know, you can't use the community water things, and the restaurant and bar are shut down, but you can play golf.
Hey, Tom, thanks again.
You bet.
Did you say the courses were open?
Yeah. Golf has been deemed an essential service in the state of Arizona. They can't shut them down.
I don't see that happening out here.
By order of the governor.
No, it's not here. They shut us down. And I live on a golf course.
You know, it's 75, 80 degrees, so, you know, it kills the virus, so we're doing our part.
That's exactly right.
We got that damp rain stuff here. When are you back in Florida, Tom?
Oh, let's see. I got to dodge this lighting here. I'm probably not going back to Florida for a while. I'm not going on the road for a while.
Okay. Yeah, I'm kind of stuck here, too, and I got a lot of work there I got to get done with. Tons.
Yeah. Well, we're about 7 minutes out or so.
Yeah, about six, 7.
Is anybody else going to show slides or share slides or anything like that?
Oh, hang on, guys. I got to take this.
Not that I know of, Tom. It's all you.
All right. Well,
there might be a couple NAFLE ones to open with, but.
Okay, well, let me just make sure you can see this. Just a second here. I'm just trying to see which one I'm doing. Let's see. Let me see if you can see this now.
Oh, God, that's good.
There. Can you see good. That?
Yeah.
All right. Well, then I'll just leave that up for now.
Yeah, if Suzanne comes on, she may do her sharing, but she can at least share back or whatever. I don't know.
I'll just stop sharing and then she can share, and then I just wanted to make sure it was working.
Morning, everyone.
That's Larry.
Jeez, I see a typo on my own slide. That's funny. That is funny.
Oh.
Jeez. Well, you know, I kind of put this together at the last second, so.
If that's the only one, you're in pretty good shape.
It looks like I need a space in there, too. There we go.
Your son all moved out?
Oh, I got to move him today.
Where's he at again?
He's at GCU Grand Canyon, just down the road. So as soon as this is done, I'm taking my pickup and we're going to load up his stuff and move it.
Heard nothing but good things about that school.
Yeah, it's a good school.
Good morning.
Good morning.
Morning, Cam.
Hi, Cammy.
Morning. How is everybody?
Good.
We're good. We're just good.
Thanks for joining. Great. Thanks for joining us, Tom.
You bet.
The hell is that?
Dog. Probably Drew's dog. So what I'd recommend is once this thing starts, whoever's not talking, just mute your line because you can hear everything typing, things, you know, shuffling your feet, all that comes through.
Yep. I actually think she puts everybody on mute from her control panel, except for the speaker.
That's true.
There's Suzanne right there.
Yep.
The brain trust. Tom is already with us. He didn't know he didn't know if he had other slides, but he put them up.
Yeah, we do. We have a couple of slides, and then we'll hand it over to you, and then you can share.
Okay, so I stopped sharing, so now you can share.
Okay, wonderful.
Great. Good morning, everyone, or afternoon, depending where you're located, and welcome to our NAFA Town Hall. I'm Larry Holzberg, NAFA's secretary. I want to thank everyone for being here. And I'd also like to tell you, as we help elevate the industry, we've invited our friends from our sister organization, partner organizations, to join us. So anybody from them, we welcome you to our event. We have a good agenda today. I'm going to try to dive in quickly so we can get through everything and get to our guest speaker, Tom Hegner, and give him as much time as possible. Quickly on our agenda today, Kevin will give you a quick update, our CEO. Suzanne Carwin will give us an update on some COVID-19 resources. We have two great sessions coming to balance it this week. Ike Trotter will be doing one on adapting to new technologies. And on Friday, Ryan Pinney will be doing one on how to run a virtual agency. So great, useful resources. It comes across that most of us have come up with quotes, and I found one that really hits me and talks about what we do as advisors every day about perseverance. Nelson Mandela once said, it always seems impossible until it's done. And that's the spirit of a NAFA advisor, NAFA member. So I think that's our spirit and what we do. At this point, to move the agenda along, I'm going to turn it over to Kevin to give his CEO update.
All right. Good morning or good afternoon, everybody. Thank you again for joining us here today for our third of these NAFA Town Hall meetings. Again, we're doing these to make sure that we stay in contact with our membership and keep you informed as to any updates going on regarding this COVID-19 scenario and how it might impact you and your livelihood. As Larry said, I'd like to welcome any of our friends and colleagues that have joined us from WIFS, from NALBA, from Life Happens, from NIA, from LIA, from AAIFPA. We're glad that you're here. And for any of you all that just watch us on demand later, again, we're glad you're taking a few minutes out to get an update and to hear some inspirational stuff and to keep us moving as we deal with these new times. Couple things I just wanted to bring you up to speed on regarding updates. One, can we put up that slide, Suzanne? The next slide?
Sure, we sure can.
As you all may know, just like most of you, if not all of you are doing, the NAFA headquarters staff is working from home. We shut our office down last week out of an abundance of caution to be good citizens and also make sure our staff are well protected during this time. But while we're doing that, we're still at full operations. And so please know that NAFA is in continuous contact with our government officials. We serve on a number of advisory boards, including one with FEMA and one with the White House related to financial services. So we're staying in contact with them as to what's happening and also making sure they take into account the respective of those of you that are out there serving Main Street Americans and helping them stay financially secure every day, but particularly during this time of crisis, as they continue to make decisions on our behalf as Americans. So we continue to monitor what they're doing. We continue to get out information to each of you. And one of the big things that you probably heard about is that at about 1 a.m. this morning, the leadership in the Senate, along with the White House, reached a deal regarding stage three of this coronavirus stimulus package. It's going to be massive. It'll be the biggest monetary bill the federal government has ever passed, $2 trillion worth of assistance. As soon as the final version passes, which we expect to have done by tomorrow, and then signed into law, we will, of course, dissect it, analyze it, and get the information out to each of you. But a big thing to know, which just highlights, one, it looks like right now that every American who makes less than $75,000 a year, every taxpayer, will be getting a check from the federal government in the amount of around $1,200. It looks like a comparable amount will go out to them again during the month of May. And so that'll provide some much needed financial assistance to every American or to virtually every American. Second, as part of the Stage 3 CARE Act, there is also a provision for small businesses, meaning employers with less than 500 employees, to be able to get a forgivable loan from the Small Business Administration for up to 4 months of operating expenses. And that would include things like payroll, rent slash mortgage, debt payments, and insurance payments. So again, once the final bill comes out, we'll give you guys a complete breakdown on it. But that's good news, because a lot of your folks that are really worried about, can I put food on the table because I'm an hourly employee, at least they should be able to retain their jobs with their employers through those forgivable loans from the SBA. So again, more to come on that, but good news that last night the leadership seems to have reached a consensus on that. Over the course of the next 2 months, we'll be doing a lot of our meetings virtually, both chapter meetings, local and state, as well as NAFA itself. So we'll be doing this kind of communication, but it's still a great way for you to still keep in contact with each other. And in times like this, it's important for professional associations to do that, to provide that sense of community, to provide that safety net, and to let you know that you are not alone, that we're all in this thing together, and your professional association, NAFA, is going to do our best to keep you connected and keep you informed at this time. The Congressional Conference is currently still scheduled for May 19th and 20th. But again, situations are unfolding rapidly, and we're continuing to work with various parties involved to figure out if that's the right thing for us to do during the month of May. So we will be out with the communication on that, my guess is, before the end of next week, but probably in less time than that, letting you know what the final status is regarding CONCON 2020. Because first and foremost, our main concern is the health and safety of our members. And we want to make sure that if the event does go off, that of course you're safe. So stay tuned, more information to come on that soon. And then to let you know again, as NAFA always has your back, we have been reaching out to our company leaders around the country to make sure that there's no interruption in the compensation that comes to each of you as producers, letting them know again, we're all in this thing together, that your distribution force depends upon income, just like everyday Americans depend upon their income. And so we hope that they, as leaders in the industry, will make sure that the profession is well protected over the weeks ahead. So yet another example of how we constantly have your back. And with that, I will pass it over to Suzanne for some quick updates on some COVID-19 resources, and then we'll get to the real reason we're all here, and that's to hear from Tom.
Thank you, Kevin. We had on Monday and Tuesday this week, we went over some of the new resources that we have under our brand new member site. And I'll just say that we've added now the collaborative library that we talked about. So if you have materials from your clients, et cetera, that you want to turn in to help the greater NAFA Nation, please go ahead and do so. You can send that to info@NAFA.org or to membernews@NAFA.org. And what I wanted to just update everybody on today was that we have moved and we've gotten a lot of new attention. We've reached out to our legislators at both the state and federal levels to let them know that we're on top of it, in particular on phishing, cybersecurity, and personal identity scams. And so what we've gotten tremendously great feedback back from them, to the point where they said, could you put together a social media kit for us so that we could go ahead and send that out to our own constituents? And I'm just gonna share that really quickly, because I'm happy to also send this to anyone else that would like to have this. It goes with our new financialsecurity.org consumer site. And you can see that we have put together Twitter, Instagram, Facebook posts and images that you can use very quickly. All of our new channels have launched, and you'll see some of our members have already gone ahead and created videos up there. They're now posted, going to specific topics. So if you want to be a part of that too, the sign-up sheet for that is within the members under Participate in COVID-19 Financial Security. With that, I'm going to go ahead and pass it back over to Larry.
Thank you, Suzanne. Thanks to the whole team at the home office for keeping us up and running and doing such a great job. We're a fortunate organization to have great leaders, speakers. And today, we're very honored to have Tom Hegner speak to us today. He's going to give us a talk about opportunities that abound in today's environment. It's also a little teaser because Tom's going to be one of our main stage presenters at P+P. Most of you know Tom. He has had a multi-billion dollar impact on the insurance industry and what we do. Best way to sum up what Tom does is he's been inducted both Louisiana and Arizona's NAFA Hall of Fames. So he's a NAFA member for years, a supporter of our organization, and he's trained over 300,000 financial advisors. So we are fortunate to have someone of his abilities to share some time today with us to help us get through this crisis and make some opportunities. Tom, thanks for being here. We look forward to listening.
Thank you. And let me just, let me share my screen here. Look, I put this thing together in about 48 hours. Okay, can you see my screen there, Suzanne? Can you see everything? Okay. And so, you know, back in the late 80s, there was a recession in America, and I was a brand new agent, and there was a guy by the name of Harvey Cook, who was kind of a legend at MetLife at the time. And he got up and said that he was choosing not to participate in the recession. And I'm sitting in the back of the room, I'm saying, who is this guy saying he's choosing not to participate in the recession? But you want to know what it made me think? Well, Harvey had his best year ever, and I had my best year ever. And so what I want to get across is that you can choose not to participate in all the negativity that's out there. I'm going to share some things with you today. It's going to be a little different than any of my other presentations. And again, I just put this together in the last 48 hours. And if you've been following me on social media, I posted 12 ideas on how to take advantage of this situation. So I'm going to be going through those 12 ideas and giving you some commentary. But you're going to find three themes that I'm going to talk about. Number one, I'm going to talk about attitude. You got to get your mind right in times like this. There's going to be so much negativity going on. You got to choose not to participate in that. And a book that helped me when I was brand new is a book by the name of Think and Grow Rich. And I know many of you have read it. If you haven't, I would encourage you to get it. It will get your mind straight. And you'll find that your mind is a supercomputer, and you can literally do anything that you put your mind to, okay? I also watched all kinds of VHS tapes of the Kinder Brothers. And the Kinder Brothers taught me words and language and questions and stories to share with clients. And they really fast-tracked me to the top. I went to MDRT. I ordered all their cassette tapes of the top producers around the world. And when I was driving around, or if you're sitting around now, you can be listening to things like that. So you're going to see a theme, number one, of attitude. Number two, you're going to see a theme of activity. You've got to maintain activity that's different than your normal activity. And you're going to hear me say that you got to calendar it too, because if it's on the calendar, you'll do it. If it's not on the calendar, you're probably not going to do it. Understand, I'm in the same situation as you. I'm a speaker. How many events do you think I'm speaking at in the next 3 months? Everything is canceled. Like $250,000 of speaking contracts are gone, okay? But I've already kind of made the transition to doing webinars and moving things online. And what I'm telling you is you've got to make that transition too. You've got to do things differently. You've got to be creative. You've got to think outside the box. Remember, for all the people that are having bad times, there are some people that this is the boom time for them. You know, people in the medical field are working overtime. They're probably making more than ever. Many of the first responders are working more than ever. Truck drivers, delivery people. There are industries and people that are having their boom time right now. So you've got to be thinking about that, and you've got to find some of those things. And the last theme that I'm going to share with you is on your own personal development and training, because now is the time for you to sharpen your blade. Now's the time for you to get better than you've ever been. Now's the time for you to learn how to handle objections and do all that. So that's kind of going to be my theme. And again, I'm going to apologize if this seems like this is about me. It's not about me. It's about you. And I'm going to try to give some ideas. But again, I put this together in 48 hours. So you're going to see, you know, some of my stuff in here. And again, I apologize for that. Let me get right to it. Okay. So idea number one, why don't you make movie night for your clients? You know, there are DVDs out there. I've got a couple of them. That Don't Worry, Retire Happy is one of mine. I got David McKnight's Power of Zero. There are other DVDs out there that will help you with your clients. You can make movie night. You put it in a bucket of popcorn with two Cokes and a candy. You can leave it right on their doorstep. You can say, hey, I need it back in 2 or 3 days. But what if your clients were watching things like this? Because our industry was built for times like these. We've got guarantees. See, in times of uncertainty, people crave certainty, and we've got that. So make movie night. Instead of them watching Netflix every night, why don't you have them watch something that you want them to watch? Number two, drop off books for them to read. You know, there's not just my books. There's David McKnight's books. You might have other books that are favorite to you, but they've got time now to read. So have them read things. I put my books up here because I know they've resulted in hundreds of millions of dollars of annuity and life insurance sales just from people reading the books. And they call up their advisor, say, I need to buy this. Idea number three, run virtual appointments every day. You got to use Zoom. We're using Zoom today, but you can use WebEx. You can use FaceTime. You can use Join Me. Join Me is free if you're just doing a few of them. Call your clients. Just ask them, how are you doing? And then try to do annual reviews. Say, hey, we do business very differently here at our firm. And I'm setting up times to do an annual review. It's a perfect time. I can put all your statements up on the screen. We can answer any questions. We can review your whole situation. But again, put this activity on your calendar and try to run some virtual appointments every day. Number four. Use this time to sharpen your blade, learn, study, train. I've got resources, Tom Hagnon Demand. I did 3 free webinars. And so if you would go to any one of my social media sites, Facebook or LinkedIn, and you go through my posts, all the links are there. And maybe I can get the links to Suzanne if she wants to do that, but there are free webinars. I have a free YouTube channel. David McKnight has references. David Kinder, if you go to his site, he's got all kinds of free training things on his site. So, you got Ed Slott out there. You got Van Miller. So there are plenty of places to go, but use this time to get better at what you do. I know NAFA has some resources. I know the Alliance for Lifetime Income, retireyourrisk.org has resources. So look up these resources to do study and training. Keep that positive attitude. You know, I learned from the Kinder brothers, if it's to be, it's up to me. Choose not to participate in this upcoming recession. Find people who are having great times and go out to talk to them. And then all these people who've lost money in the market, you see, I wish people would have moved their money out of the market when it was an all-time record high. In fact, I put out a video. Some of you saw it. It was why every investor needs an annuity now. And I put that out 2 weeks before the market crashed. And it didn't get a lot of traction. Well, then the market crashed. And then everybody's going, oh, wow, I wish I would have bought that annuity. Yeah. But see, they will only typically listen when there are bad times. They don't always listen in the good times. And I wish they did, but they don't. But they'll listen now. And so now's the time that you've got to stress the guarantees of life insurance, the guarantees of annuities, the importance of having a plan for long-term care. This is what we do. And now we're in the mode to listen to us. And again, I can't stress enough that you've got to put these things on your calendar and hold yourself accountable. You know, every day I put things on my calendar and I have a list right on my desk of the things that I need to accomplish for that day. And I'm going through step by step by step. There's all kinds of things that I still need to get done. And I put it down, I write it down, and I don't leave my office until those things get done. And if you can hold yourself accountable, just even 4 or 5 things every day that you get done, that you make those 10 or 15 calls, that you are doing the things that you need to do, hold yourself accountable, because it is so easy when you have an open calendar to just kind of fritter the day away. Well, I think I'm going to go in my office. Well, I probably should make a call. Well, now that's on CNBC. What's happening with the market? And all of a sudden the day ends and you didn't get anything done. So I would encourage you to put it on your calendar, hold yourself accountable. If you have not started doing webinars, I would encourage you to start doing webinars. They're not hard to do. They're easy. I did a free webinar that you can watch on how to do webinars or seminars. The title of the webinar is How to Do Seminars, but it's the same three key steps to doing a webinar. And there's three simple key things to having a successful webinar. Number one, you got to fill the seat or fill the registration. You got to have attendees at your webinar. Number two, you need to have a very good process. You need to know what to do before the webinar, what to do during the webinar, what to do after the webinar. And number three, you better have some powerful content. And that's what I cover inside of that free webinar. So if you're thinking about that, you might want to do that. Idea number seven, study the products that you sell. Do you know how many advisors I've been with who are selling indexed annuities or selling something and they really don't know how the product works? They don't know what's guaranteed, what's not guaranteed, how the resets work, how the different indexes work. Now's your time. Read the brochures, read the prospectuses, study them. And not only your stuff, study your competitors' products. I always tell the story when I was a new agent, I was doing what new agents do. What do? They sell mortgage protection, right? So we get a new homeowner list. I go out and I'd sell, you know, mortgage protection. I was a new agent. I sold mainly term at the beginning. At the time I was with MetLife, but I was getting my butt kicked by New York Life. And I'm saying, how am I losing all these cases to New York Life? So finally I dug into that policy and I found that at that time, New York Life had a lower first year term premium. Remember, this was before there was 5-year, 10-year. This was annual renewable term, okay? And they had a lower first year rate, but their second, third, fourth, fifth, sixth year were higher. And so once I learned that, I was able to show the client, yeah, it looks like it's lower, but let me show you the 5-year cost, the 10-year cost. I never lost another case, all right? And then I went to work for New York Life for 15 years. But my point is, it's the time right now to know your products and know your competitors' products. You've got time to study that, so put that on your calendar. Know what fees that your products charge, know the features, know all the benefits, know the performance, know any of the weaknesses in your products, and know the weaknesses of your competition. Idea number eight, develop a library of disinterested third-party references, okay? Look, you have a conflict of interest with your clients because if you sell something, you get paid. If you don't sell something, you don't get paid. And they know that. And your company has a conflict of interest because if they buy, the company gets paid. And if they don't, the company doesn't get paid. So company brochures are good only so far. You want to have some references of people who don't get paid. Dr. David Babel, Dr. Wade Fow, Dr. Michael Finke, Dr. Robert C. Merton, my stuff, David McKnight stuff, Van Miller stuff. None of us get paid whether they buy or not. We are disinterested third parties. And so use books, use articles, use white papers. I have a white paper on the screen there, Retirement Alpha. The nice thing about that is what I did is I went around the country and found all these white papers that deal with retirement. And I summarized all of them and put them into my own white paper. But they have all the references there. So you can click on, you can get on the references and then you can pull up the actual white papers. And I would have a book of those. And I would just have third party disinterested, you know, things from Forbes magazine, things. And people say, oh, well, you can't do that for compliance. No, that's not completely true. Yes, you can't highlight the article. You can't tear it out. But as long as you use the entire document, most companies, you can use that. So again, I would use disinterested third party references. Idea number nine, if you have not read David McKnight's Power of Zero book, I would get that. I would read it and I would start sharing it because, you know, we just passed, they said $2 trillion. Some people think it'll eventually be 4 trillion or whatever trillion. We are already 23 trillion in the hole. Who do you think is going to get us out of this hole? What do you think is going to happen? They're going to have to raise taxes at some point. This is not a Republican issue. This is not a Democrat issue. This is a math problem, okay? We need a math party. We need a party that can actually add and subtract. And what I'm telling you is taxes are going to go up in the future. So do we have anything that we could recommend to clients to help them avoid paying these taxes? How about Roth IRA conversions? The market's down. You convert now at a sale price. And when the market goes back up, all that's tax-free. What about permanent life insurance that they can take money out in retirement tax-free? I am telling you, David McKnight's message is going to be more powerful now than ever before because taxes are going to have to go up. It's just a matter of math. Idea number 10, work on your questioning skills. I always say this, telling is not selling. Listening is selling. Asking is selling. You want to increase your production? Increase your questions. I have Mar Feldman's book up there, Man on a Mission. You know, I have that up there. It's one of the best books in the entire world on asking questions. He has so many powerful questions. Remember, that's the Feldman family. It's not just Mar Feldman. It was Ben Feldman, his father, best life insurance salesperson ever. Wendy Feldman, she's one of my advisors out here in Arizona. You've got a family that has spent their entire lives in this industry, and he shares their secrets in that book. And the questions in there are worth gold. So I would get a copy of that book. I would start incorporating those questions. I put Retirement Income Masters up there because if you know about what Masters is, what I did with that book is I went around the country and I found 14 top producers. These are advisors like you. And each chapter is their story. What do they say? How do they explain it? How do they explain these concepts? And that book is loaded with questions as well. You can get on the internet. You can Google it for free and just find out more powerful questions, but work on your questioning skills. That's one of the biggest weaknesses, especially among newer advisors. They're into, oh, my product does this and it does this and it slices and it does. That doesn't matter. What matters is what's important to the client. Get better at asking questions and you will be a better advisor. Idea number 11, in times of uncertainty, people crave certainty, which is what our industry provides. We have guarantees. We have guaranteed lifetime income. We have guaranteed tax-free benefits. We have guaranteed death benefits. We have guaranteed premiums. We have guarantees that other advisors can't talk about. These brokers, and you know why they're called brokers, don't you? Because your clients are broker than they were 2 months ago, okay? But the brokers can't use the word guarantee. When they say the word guarantee, they take them out in handcuffs, okay? We can say the word guarantee because our products are guaranteed. And remember, guarantees really only matter in times just like these. Idea number 12, webinars, webinars, webinars. Now I told you there's three key things. Number one, you gotta fill the seats. Number two, it's a process. Number three, it's content. Well, in my webinar, I help you with the process and I help you with the content, but I can't fill the seats for you, but White Glove can. White Glove has moved from doing just seminars to doing webinars. And I just had a call with them this week. And I don't get any compensation for saying any of this. I'm just saying I've worked with them in the past. They're very good and they can fill that room for you. They're not cheap. It's going to cost you some money, but they will fill your webinar for you if you want to. Okay. Idea number 13, let your clients know that you sell life insurance. There are so many people out there who think that companies have stopped selling life insurance because of this virus. Let them know that's not the case, that you can still get them life insurance in times like these. So anyway, those were my main comments. I wanna just do a couple things and then I'll turn it back over. Number one, people don't understand how underinsured they are for life insurance. Let me tell you what, every one of your clients is underinsured for life insurance. And I know that sounds crazy, but it's not, and I'll try to prove it to you. In a 1% interest rate environment, we are right now in a 1% interest rate environment. How much life insurance invested at 1% would it take to cover 50,000 of income? The answer is $5 million, all right? How many of your clients that make $50,000 a year are walking around with $5 million? And how many of you that are making $200,000, $300,000, $400,000 are walking around with $20, $30, $40 million with life insurance? Now you say, Tom, that is crazy. Okay, how much life insurance would you need if interest rates were 5%? They're not, but if they were, how much life insurance would you need at 5% to protect 50,000 of income? The answer is $1 million. That is not crazy. What I'm telling you is your client should have at least $1 million of life insurance for every 50,000 of income. Now, some of you think that's too much as well. Well, let me tell you a story, and this is a true story. It happened when I was writing the conclusion of book number two, Retirement Income Masters. I've been on the road for 13 straight days. I was leaving to go on the road for another 6 days. I was home for one single day out of a 20-day stretch, and I got a call from my oldest boy, Ryan. He said, Dad, I need a favor. My best friend's brother died 3 weeks ago, and his wife, the widow, just got the check, and it's a big check, and she wants to meet with you on Saturday. I said, Ryan, what does she want to meet with me for? I don't sell any financial products at all. I'm a speaker, author, full-time. He said, well, that's why she wants to meet with you, because she knows you know this stuff, and you're not going to try to sell her anything. I said, Ryan, I've been gone for 13 days. I'm leaving for 6 days. I got one day at home. I'm not driving around the valley looking for somebody who wants to talk to me, but I said, here's what I'll do. If they want to come to my house, I will meet with them at 9 a.m. on Saturday. Well, the widow, the dad, and the brother show up at my house. She was 42 years of age, two little girls, husband killed unexpectedly, $1 million death claim. After I gave her my condolences, she said these words to me. She said, Tom, I never thought I'd be a millionaire. Now, here's what I want to do. I want to build a custom house on a lake with a place for my daughters to play. I don't want a cookie cutter house. I want a custom house on a lake, place for my daughters to play. I literally had to stop her mid-sentence and say, ma'am, time out. We're not talking any custom houses today. You only have $1 million. In a 1% interest rate environment, that's $10,000 a year. I am here to see how you and your daughters can possibly survive on $10,000 a year. Now, maybe you could get $20,000, maybe $30,000, $35,000, $38,000, but no expert I know says you can take out 4%. 4% is going to fail, especially this has to last her for 50 or 60 years. I said max, and this is pushing it, you are a $38,000 a year woman. You're not a millionaire. There's no custom houses I know of at $38,000 a year. She was shocked. What are you talking about? My husband made $250,000 a year. We can't live on $38,000 a year. Ladies and gentlemen, how many of your clients do you think are just like this widow who thought she was a millionaire, who is now stuck living a $38,000 a year life with her two little girls in Arizona? So I'm telling you, you have a powerful message to say. See, on the day you die, your spouse is going to ask four simple questions. And it's not going to be, do we have term life or whole life or variable life or index life? Do we have Met Life or New York Life or State Farm? Those aren't going to be the four questions. The four questions your spouse is going to ask, how much life insurance do we have? How long will the dollars last? Can we stay in our same house and can the kids go to the same school? My question is, what do you want the answers to be? We have things we can talk to our clients about, and these are the things we need to know. And remember, there are two emotions out there right now. There's fear and there's greed. And there's probably more fear right now than greed. Greed is when they say, oh, my broker got me 37% last year and I don't need your products because your product don't do it good. But they're motivated by greed. And when you have somebody who's motivated by greed, you got to show them how your products can perform, how they can deliver results and all the benefits. When they're motivated by fear, they're scared to death about everything. That's when you talk about the guarantees and the certainty that we offer. So really, that's what I had for you today. I'm going to turn it back over. I hope that was helpful. I'm here if you want to ask questions. I don't know, Suzanne, if you want to take over on that or if we're out of time, I don't know, but thank you very much for having me today.
Thank you, Tom. Virtual claps forever. All I'll say is that was 20 minutes. Can you imagine what P plus P is going to be like? That was amazing. And I think everybody has to realize, you know, some thoughts. And the abnormal now is our new normal and how we react to it's really important. And I will tell you this, people want to hear from us. I have my own client this morning at 9 o'clock, him and his wife, he's a pulmonologist in Florida. You can imagine what he's going through right now. And one, they were concerned about more coverage, but he also thanked me and his wife thanked me because God forbid something happens while he's protecting people, they're protected. What we do is so vital. We should never take a step back and remind people of how important what we do as an industry and for people. Tom, that was great. Suzanne, do we have a few minutes if anybody has any quick questions?
Yeah, we sure do.
All right, so.
Yeah, the biggest question I see that's come up, Tom, is could you just repeat the four questions I think we're saying pertaining to life insurance, that when your spouse dies, you're gonna ask four questions?
Yeah, let me share that again. I can pop that right back up. Just 1 second.
Okay, great.
Let me just share it. There we go. How much life insurance do we have? How long will the dollars last? Can we stay in our same house? Can the kids go to the same school? I'll leave those up there.
You know, no matter how long we're in this business or no matter how much the world changes, those four questions never change for every family. Everybody buys from their heart, not from their head. And these are the hard questions that matter. And as we close our session today, one, I want to really give credit to this organization, this association, and this team. What they've put together in such a short period of time to provide these events, these educational events, these ideas. I know every one of us can now make a phone call today and have a little more confidence in talking to our clients. At NAFA, we can do anything, and we are. So we look forward to continuing our town halls this week. Once again, Ike Trotta tomorrow's going to talk about adapting to technology and new changes. And then on Friday, Ryan Penny on how to run your agency virtually. I want to thank everyone. Make sure everybody stays safe and well. And see everyone tomorrow afternoon. And have a great day. And thanks for being here.
Thanks, everybody. Be well.